AFR On Demand is brought to you by Breck Golf. Try Beaver Creek today, just 20 minutes from downtown Baton Rouge in the Zachary area. They've got a PGA Tour driving range, a short game practice area, 30 to 40 yard practice shots. It's a great place to chip and putt and practice if you don't have time for a full round. Book your tee time today, golf.breck.org, golf.breck.org.
Matt Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
Let's
I'm standing. Hour three, off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us. AFR, presented by Insurance Network of Louisiana. I'm Matt.
This is Shaq O'Neal, and I hate Matt.
Paul O'Neal.
They're chanting Paul O'Neal's name.
Music. And Mr. Toby Tomplay. We're here. Glad you are as well. Get out there and make it a good one. 5 o'clock quitting time. Glad you're driving home with us. We are 1 hour away from LSU and Kentucky at the Maravich Center. Some 43 minutes away from the unveiling of Dale Brown Court. If you are getting out to the Maravich Center, if you're in traffic or if you ain't started yet, you're probably going to miss it, man, because it's always jam-packed when it's LSU and Kentucky. And, of course, with all the emotion surrounding this game, with the unveiling of Dale Brown Court, et cetera, it is certainly going to be a packed environment, a great night for basketball at the Maravich Center. I think LSU is going to get this win tonight. But they're to do so, to bounce back, they'll have to beat a Kentucky team, which is noticeably different in its makeup than what we've come to expect over the years from John Calipari teams. This is a Kentucky team that is a contrast to what Calipari typically does, which is build a roster of one and dones. Because of COVID and how that altered the AAU cycle in 2020, it altered last year's recruiting class and these current rosters. So instead, now look, Ty Washington's on the team. He's a top 20 national player. But mostly what Calipari did was, instead of bringing in the five-star freshman this year, he brought in transfers. Oscar Tshiebwe transferred in from West Virginia. He's averaging 15 and 15. Thank you very much. Sevier Wheeler from Georgia last year, freshman All-SEC. If you remember, LSU played Georgia twice, and Wheeler went off in both games. LSU escaped at the Maravich Center and got pounded in Athens by Georgia, and Wheeler was awesome both times. He's not a huge scoring threat, but he runs the point. He distributes the basketball. Left Georgia because they're a dumpster fire. Went to Kentucky, and he's running the show there. Grady. Transferred in from Davidson. He's their three-point specialist. Really the only guy on this roster that actually attempts, really shoots three-pointers. C.J. Frederick's another one, transferred in from Iowa, but he's injured. He injured his hamstring, had surgery, he's done for the year. So, very different approach than what John Calipari typically does. But Will Wade talked about it when he met with the media. This is number 7, where he said this is going to be the most physical game they play regardless.
It's going to be the most physical game we've played all year. They're physical, 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 especially down low. Their guards are physical. Their wings are physical. I mean, they're just physical. His teams always are. And so, you know, we're going to have to do a good job keeping it front of mind and put a body on them. Keep a body on them and stay in between them and the basket, which is a lot easier said than done.
A body between them and the basket, easier said than done. this is what Kentucky does. Kentucky is top 10 in the country in both offensive and defensive efficiency because they're great at rebounding. And they shoot a high percentage because they don't shoot threes. Grady is 50% from three on the year. He's attempted 76 three-pointers. He's 50% from three. But Kentucky is one of the worst in the country, at the bottom of the country in percentage of offense from three-pointers. They don't shoot threes. That's what John Calipari's teams do. They're more athletic than you, so they get to the rim and they finish. If they don't, they rebound and they finish. That's what they do. And they defend like crazy. Cal's teams have always done that. So that's what this game is going to be. When they lost to Notre Dame, they lost 66-62. Low-scoring game. Kentucky was 2 of 19 from 3 in that game. Notre Dame got him out of sorts. They didn't let him in the paint. They forced him to shoot threes. Kentucky don't shoot threes. So they were 2 of 19. That's 10.5% from 3 if you can't do the math. And Notre Dame won that game 66-62 in South Bend. Cal's teams always defend. They allow 60 points a game. The question for me is, can LSU score in transition? Can they force turnovers? Kentucky's really good. They only had 5 turnovers in that game against Notre Dame where they lost. They didn't turn the ball over. They just couldn't throw it in the ocean. LSU's got to protect the rim. They got to keep Kentucky out of the paint. You heard Will say it. Got to put a body between them and the basket. Keep them out of the paint. Don't let them get easy buckets. Defend like you have all year, and you should be fine in this game. I'll be very interested about Tari Eason, who's been injured. Of course, Tari Eason missed the Tech game. You got him back. He played 26 minutes, came off the bench, played 26 minutes in the SEC opener against Auburn. And then Brandon Murray as well, who missed last week. Will Wade.
Murray, present.
Thank you. Will Wade did give an update on Brandon Murray yesterday. Here's what Will Wade said.
Yeah, we'll see. It'll be a game time decision tomorrow. He's done some shooting. He's done a little bit in practice. So we'll have to see how he feels tomorrow. We thought he was going to be able to give it a go at Auburn and shoot around. It was too tough. So he was back there getting treatment before I walked in here. So we'll see. We'll see how it is. But we certainly need him. He's a huge, huge piece to what we do on both ends.
Look, it completely shuffled the starting lineup. It forced Justice Williams into his first action of the year. You want to be whole in this game. Brandon Murray for sure is a big piece of it. But you've also got to get Tari Eason healthy because he's your best player. After the game, the loss to Auburn, Sharif O'Neal tweeted that he's fully cleared. So Will Wade was also asked for an update on Sharif.
He's practiced a little bit. He's been on and off. So hopefully, he would be 10, yes. I mean, he would be in the 10.
And he can.
We dressed him out at Auburn.
Yeah, you can play him now.
I mean, we could play him. I have to get clearance from doctor on game day. We had clearance at Auburn to play him maybe 5 minutes if we needed him. I would assume we could probably get that tomorrow if we needed it, but I don't know till I meet with Sean. I meet with Sean and he talks to our team doctor the day of the game, and they go through it and go over it. But yeah, I would certainly expect we'd have clearance to play him limited minutes the next, potentially the next couple games.
So a possibility you could see Sharif O'Neal make his season debut tonight for LSU against Kentucky. And one more, obviously a gigantic story in this game is going to be Efton Reed avoiding the type of dominance which happened against Walker Kessler against Auburn. There's a player like that, just like there's a player like that for damn near every team in the SEC, and it's Shibuye tonight. So what about that matchup? Here's what Will Wade had to say.
I mean, he's different, but he's the most effective rebounder in the country. He's the most effective offensive rebounder in the country. They're the most effective. I mean, they're a tremendous offensive rebounding team because of him, because of Brooks. You can't forget about Ware. You can't forget about Collins, who's a tremendous, tremendous athlete as well. They just go about it in a, they go about it different way. They're like top 15 in the country in defensive rebounding too. So we're not going to be able to get a bunch of offensive rebounds. But I mean, Oscar's just big and physical and just throws you out of the way and goes and gets the ball. And then he finishes at the front of the rim. Like I said, I mean, he averages 6 offensive rebounds a game. Days and Easton are the only 2 guys we got that average more than 6 rebounds a game total.
But LSU has good numbers, and they will have emotion on their side tonight. I don't think there's any doubt that's a huge part of this tonight and will be in every game this year said it, I'm going to keep saying it, that home court advantage this year in college basketball is worth more than it ever has been before, because college basketball players that are in their first or second year will have never experienced something like this. LSU is a 2-point favorite in this ballgame tonight. That is the consensus pick, is the Tigers are a slight favorite over Kentucky tonight at home at the Maravich Center. Tip-off is in 49 minutes from right now. And again, the Dale Brown Court ceremony is going to happen at 5:45 Central Time. So LSU, I think, gets this win tonight. I think they get even in conference play. Big game at home this weekend against Tennessee that I think they'll win that one as well. You're going to hear me pick LSU to win their home games. A lot of people spooked because of what happened at Auburn, and I sort of understand that. It was a very bad look. But Auburn's a tough place to play. Will Wade's never won there. That's a good team. It was not a good matchup. LSU got behind early. They couldn't dig themselves out. I like LSU in this ballgame, and I think they're going to win it. All right, so after further review, we're going to go to Houston in about 15 minutes from right now. Matt Trent from WBRZ Television is going to be with us. Final scene setter preview for the Texas Bowl. I mean, it's all ESPN tonight. 6 o'clock ESPN, LSU, Kentucky. As soon as that game ends, they'll shoot you over to Houston for LSU and K-State in the Texas Bowl. We'll get an update in about 15 minutes from right now. But today, a massively impactful day in LSU sports history on the calendar for a couple of reasons. We'll talk about it next. It's AFR.
AFR.
Brought to you by Clegg's Nursery. Buy local, shop local for 60 years. Our friends at Clegg's Nursery, they have been the largest garden center in Louisiana, serving Louisianians for 6 decades, man. No matter where you are in the greater Baton Rouge area, Siegenair Airline, LA 16 in Denham. As a matter of fact, last week when I was off, we drove, Terrio and Tilly and I with Hudco drove to go see a customer in Livingston Parish, and we were going down to LA 16. And man, you go way down LA 16 when you see that Clegg's Nursery. There's not a garden center within a 5-mile radius. If you're in Livingston, if you're in Denham, you know where that Clegg's is, and that's your spot. Mid-City on Donmore, Garden Center on Greenwell Springs. A lot of people, now that the holidays are done, you're starting to clean up the house from those Christmas decorations, just cleaning the house. Remember, Clegg's is part of a True Value Hardware store. Anything you'd find at a True Value Hardware store, you'll also find at Clegg's Nursery. So buy local, shop local. Tell them Matt sent you in to Clegg's Nursery.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by Insurance Network of Louisiana, call for a free quote to see how much you can save. 293-0450. After further review with Matt Moscona, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
All right, rolling along here on a Tuesday edition of AFR. Love telling you about Relief Windows, reliefwindows.com, Windows Door Siding, Relief Windows, and reliefwindows.com. Had a buddy yesterday, actually had someone send me a text on the text line. A listener said, hey, does Relief Windows do siding in New Orleans? Yes, and yes, they're all over the state of Louisiana. They're in Beaumont. They're in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Check out our friends at Relief Windows. Energy efficient replacement windows, beautiful entry doors, hardy plank vinyl siding. They do it all. It is Relief Windows and reliefwindows.com. This is January the 4th. Is a very, very special day in my life and in the lives of many listening, even if you don't know it, because it was exactly 18 years ago today that one of the greatest moments in my life as a sports fan happened.
First down play, Vincent the freshman, breaks free in the secondary, foot race, he can go the distance, Slate trips him up at the 19-yard line.
18 years ago, that was LSU's first offensive play, Justin Vincent. LSU beat Oklahoma 21-14 to win the 2003 BCS National Championship in the January of 2004 Sugar Bowl. It was a Sunday night in the Superdome, and it was a week of festivities that I and many of you will never forget. And I don't know when this happened that I turned in like to the old guy saying, gather around, kids, and let me explain to you how it was back in my day. because there are many of you far older than I that can remember many more of the 45 years between LSU's championships. But I will tell you with this perspective, because I know now when I say it's been 18 years since LSU won that championship, there are so many people listening today that if you're inside of 25 years old, you have no recollection of LSU as anything other than a national power winning championships. That's an awful lot of you listening right now. And that season was so memorable. It was my senior year at LSU. 2003 was my senior season. I graduated in 04. And growing up an LSU fan, a national championship always felt like forbidden fruit. It just felt like something that was for other programs and not us. It just didn't feel realistic. When LSU made it to a bowl game in 1995 and they went to the Independence Bowl, it felt like they had struck gold. I mean, to go through the 2003 season and to start to believe with every passing win that happened, I mean, even the elation of the Georgia win, followed by the disappointment of the Florida loss at home, it just never felt before 2003 like that was something that LSU could achieve. But as that season unfolded and you started stockpiling wins and you started realizing the possibility and you realized just how good that defense was. I remember when they beat Louisiana Tech and throttled a really good Louisiana Tech offense and then went to Oxford and beat Ole Miss because Eli fell down. That's when you knew that it wasn't only realistic, like it was going to happen, that there wasn't a team in America that was going to be able to put together enough offense against that defense to score that included Oklahoma and Jason White, the Heisman winner. The thing that context is probably in history is probably lost with that game is just how dominant that Oklahoma team was. That Oklahoma team scored 70 points in College Station against Texas A&M. And that's when Texas A&M was still the wrecking crew. That Oklahoma offense scored on everybody until the Big 12 championship game when they lost to Kansas State, but they knew they had a game to play with. And then they went and played LSU and just got absolutely smoked by that defense. And it was a sight to behold. I was fortunate enough to watch that game in the Superdome that day with my dad and my brother. Left the Dome. We actually had cigars in our pockets for the inevitability of LSU winning this game, which we all knew was going to happen. And when Marcus Spears picked off Jason White's pass and returned it for a touchdown at the start of the second half, and LSU went up 21-7, I literally took my cigar out in the Dome, and I was damn near about to light it up because it was over. Because that defense wasn't giving up a 14-point lead. That's how dominant they were. But that team, for me, is the most special. 2019 was the most magnificent thing any of us had ever seen. 2007 was the most unrealistic, unbelievable because of all the things that unfolded and the crazy endings. But 2003 is like your firstborn. It was the one that made you believe that this is possible and everything that happened beyond it. It was such an amazing thing to watch unfold and to live through because so many LSU fans came and went and never got to experience it. So for me, January 4th, 2004 will always be a very, very special day for me, and I know for many of you as well. The juxtaposition of that day is that on this date, 3 years to the day after that win in the Superdome, is when a plane carrying Alabama coach Nick Saban touched down in Tuscaloosa from Miami. January the 4th, 2007 is when Nick Saban was introduced as Alabama's head football coach. And since then, he has embarked on a reign of terror that all of college football has had to behold and just wait for it to end because there's nothing anyone can do to disrupt it. There have been moments, LSU in 2019, you know, Clemson won a couple of national titles in the mix as well. Florida with Urban Meyer won a title back in 2008. There have been brief, fleeting moments, you know, throughout Saban's 15 years in Tuscaloosa. But for a guy who had never been in one place more than 5 years to land in Tuscaloosa and to be there for 15 years as he has, and not only to be there for 15 years, but to have won as much as he has in those 15 years. 183 wins, that's the most in college football. 6 national titles, that of course is the most in college football. 106 weeks ranked number one, that is the most in college football. They've produced 39 first-round NFL draft picks, that is the most in college football. Nick Saban is the greatest college football coach that has ever lived in any era. That's not even debatable. It's not Bear Bryant, it's not Newt Rockne, it's not anybody else from any other era. It's never been harder to win in college football because of all of the parity, because of the resources, the ability for everybody to be on TV, conference championship games, expanded schedule, a playoff where you have to win a semifinal and a final. It has never been harder to win, and nobody has won at a more dominant rate than this guy has in the hardest era ever. He's the greatest coach ever, and there's part of us all that lament the fact that, yes, he was ours and could very well have done here what he did at Tuscaloosa if he didn't have to scratch the NFL itch. We were just one stop early, but we still got 2003 because of him. And quite honestly, everything subsequent that's followed over the last near 20, 18 years because of the foundation that he laid back then. And so for that, I'm forever grateful. That's why when I talk about Nick Saban, I do so with a great amount of respect and reverence. Do I absolutely loathe the fact that he's winning in Tuscaloosa? Yes, it sucks immensely. Because you look at that longingly and saying, man, that could be ours. It was ours. But you could be Michigan State. You could have had him and lost him to the place where he went and won big. Now we're not at LSU where Alabama is because of what Nick did. But 3 national titles since 2003 playing for a 4th. That's something on January the 3rd, 2004. Or certainly the day Nick Saban was hired, nobody would have believed was a possibility, me included. So this day, I've always got it earmarked. January 4th was a magnificent day in LSU football history and for many sports fans in this part of the country, and it should be celebrated and forever will be. Even if it's Nick Saban wearing a purple shirt holding up that crystal ball. All right, it's after further review. Appreciate you for being here with us. We're brought to you by Michelli Weighing and Measurement. Michelli.com, Michelli.com. You got locations all over the United States. If you weigh or measure something, no matter what industry you're in, Michelli sells, services, and rents the products you use to weigh and measure. ISO 17025 accreditation is available. If you don't know what that is, well, you don't need it. But if you do, you know why it's so important, and they offer it at Michelli Weighing and Measurement. They've also got their track system, which is free to all Michelli clients. That allows you 24/7, 365 access to your calibration certificates. It's Michelli Weighing and Measurement. Learn more online at Michelli.com. See all the different services that they offer at Michelli.com. Michelli.com since 1947. That's Michelli.com. All right, after further review, glad to have you hanging out with us here. Matt Trent from WBRZ Television. He'll be with us from Houston coming up here in just a few minutes. By the way, if anyone is listening, this might be a long shot, but if you're listening in Houston and you're around NRG or heading that way, pop into the Bregman tailgate, take some pictures, and tag us in your tweets. I got to see how that party's going. Bregman tweeted a little bit ago a video from outside of the tailgate. And if you're not familiar, Bregman was here with us yesterday. He's throwing a big tailgate for LSU fans outside of NRG. So about 3 hours ago, he tweeted a video of their setup. So, I mean, they're right there outside of NRG. Got a big area roped off, purple and gold balloons. They got barbecue and booze and all kind of stuff. But I'm interested to see how it's going. Because yesterday he said he was hoping they'd get a couple hundred fans. I mean, bruh, free food, free beer for LSU fans, and you think only a couple of hundred are going to show up? I mean, I hope my guy got some reinforcements. That's all I'm going to say. So let me know if y'all are there, or if you know someone who is, tell them to shoot me some pictures, tweet us some pictures, videos, all that stuff.
Here's one from the LSU Tiger TV account of like the line to get in, a video from 24 minutes ago.
What's the Twitter handle?
At LSU Tiger TV. It's pretty substantial so far for Bregman, it looks like.
All right, hang on. I want to look at this. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
There might be a couple hundred people just in that video.
Oh, my God. That's so ridiculous. Oh, man. What did he expect? What did he expect? Of course this was going to happen. All right, I need more pictures. I need more updated of people who were there. And as you get closer to game time, it's just going to get busier and busier. All right, it's after further review. Let's go to Houston. Let's ask Matt Trent. Maybe he's there. All right, it's after further review. Stick around.
AFR.
AFR is brought to you by the Baton Rouge General Hospital. They're online at brgeneral.org. brgeneral.org. That's where you'll find the Baton Rouge General Hospital. Of course, they've got their primary location right there on the Bluebonnet campus. They got the Mid-City location as well, and the Ascension Neighborhood Hospital, which opened up last year. So the Baton Rouge General, and then, of course, all of their satellite locations and their express care locations all over the greater Baton Rouge area. If you want to find that location near you, just go to brgeneral.org. You can tap the locations tab, and you'll see the map of all the Baton Rouge General locations around the greater Baton Rouge area to serve you quickly and conveniently and thoroughly. Of course, the Baton Rouge General is part of the Mayo Clinic Care Network. I tell you about it often. The Mayo Clinic, one of the foremost medical facilities in the world. Their specialists, as part of the Mayo Clinic Care Network, the Baton Rouge General, your doctor here, gets access to their specialists and their research at no extra cost to you. Learn more online at brgeneral.org.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by Insurance Network of Louisiana, call for a free quote to see how much you can save. 293-0450. After further review with Matt Moscona, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
As always, we appreciate Insurance Network of Louisiana. Better coverage for less money. Stop overpaying to be underinsured. Let them shop for free. 293-0450. 293-0450 or LAinsurance.net. All right, let's go over to Houston. Our buddy Matt Trent from WBRZ Television is boots on the ground covering the game there for our news partners at Channel 2. He joins us now. How are you, man?
I guess as good as I could be, Matt. You know, all things considered, I'm pretty good. Just walking around energy right now, just getting a look at everything, and feel pretty good.
Hey, man, you're getting paid to cover a college football game. Life don't suck, bro. It's all right, man. It's all right. hey, so set the scene. Like, we were told they sold like 50,000 tickets for this game. How much of an LSU presence is there that you could tell?
Well, look, and I heard that too, but let me tell you, like, yesterday I got here at around like 2:30 and was just walking around the stadium, and there was obviously like no one here. And the few LSU fans that I saw, I mean, I walked by a couple and I said, "Hey guys, how you doing? Like, go Tigers," you know, just some pleasantries. And they were like, "Yeah, how you doing?" Like, it was just not a lot of enthusiasm yesterday. But walking around today, like, the tailgate scene looks pretty good. Obviously, Alex Redmond is doing his deal out in the parking lot with the LSU alums and whatever. And, I mean, it looks good now. But yesterday and leading up to it, it didn't look like there was a whole lot of enthusiasm out here in Texas.
I would imagine that you got a lot of Houstonians who probably just will just go to there. I mean, it's just a thing, just go to the game. You know, I mean, I would assume. I don't know how many people from Louisiana made the trip. Well, we'll see when they get in how it looks. What about Kansas State fans? Is there a bunch of Kansas State fans there?
I've seen a couple, but, you know, like, a lot of people are just wearing, like, generic purple colors, so it's kind of, like, you know, hard to tell who's who. I saw a woman in the elevator this morning in the hotel, and she had a purple face mask on, and I was like, "Oh, like, are you here for the game?" And she was like, "Yeah, here on business," and didn't even know that there was a bowl game until today. Like, we're really upset. I was like, "Okay, thanks. I'll just go along my merry way. Thank you."
Who's going to play quarterback? Do we know definitively yet?
Everything that I've been told, it looks like Jontre Kirkland. To be honest, I was told that Garrett Nussmeier's waiver has been denied, so everything is pointing towards Jontre Kirkland. Matt O'Dowd broke his leg, and the Fault kid is like the next viable backup, if that's the case. So, I mean, that's everything that I've been told. But, of course, like, LSU's Twitter account posted today a locker room shot with Nussmeier's jersey and pads and his helmet in his locker. So, I mean, who knows? But from everything that I've been told, it looks like it's going to be Jontre Kirkland.
A little gamesmanship there from LSU posting the Nussmeier photo.
Yeah.
Just kind of letting you know he's there, sort of thing. Hey, are you in the stadium?
Yeah, if you can't tell, they're doing a fantastic rendition of the national anthem, which sounds similar to calves being slaughtered, but, you know.
I can't know we could tell. I didn't know if you were outside or if you were inside, but that sort of gave it away. All right, Matt, pot him down for a second. Muse, please, thank you. Thank you, thank you. All right. No, down. Thank you. Matt Trent is our guest here for just a couple more minutes. We're going to wait till they finish off the national anthem, and we'll jump back because it's a little loud there. All right, brought to you by our friends at the Williamson Eye Center, williamsoneye.com. Sit tight, Matt. We'll get to you here in just a second once they finish that. 924-2020, 924-2020. Or the Williamson Eye Center. If you want to see 2020, call 924-2020 for the Williamson Eye Center. Of course, give yourself the gift of sight with the Williamson Eye Center. 924-2020 or williamsoneye.com. All right, we're continuing with Matt Trent from WBRZ Television. So a little bit of a lackluster mood. We're not sure about quarterback. Being there with the team, is there anything else personnel-wise you can tell us, Matt, as far as guys that maybe were a little iffy, who made the trip, who is there, who's expected to contribute?
I mean, I obviously the secondary is going to be real thin. I don't know if there's been some weird stuff going around with Dwight McLaughlin. Like, I don't know if he's here. I heard there were some disciplinary issues with him, on him maybe not making it. You know, Cordell Flott obviously is turning pro. I don't know if that means he's opting out of the bowl game or is going to play. Like, that unit is going to be thin. The linebacker unit, according to the depth chart, is only going to be Mike Jones and Greg Penn. So that, from all accounts, is going to be super, super thin. Throw that on to the quarterback issues, and, you know, we're looking at like 40 guys that are going to be on scholarship and dressed out here tonight.
What about coaching responsibilities? I mean, because there's only four guys remaining, the two coordinators, Brad Davis and Andre Carter.
Yeah, that's an interesting one. And I was asking someone today, I was like, you know, is Jake Pete here? You know, is Jake Pete going to show up? And from everything that I was told, they said that he's here and that they said that he's going to coach. I don't know. But I think that also a lot of maybe analysts have gotten promotions in the past couple of weeks just to kind of fill those full-time roles so they'll have enough. Brian Kelly's obviously going to be here. I don't know for sure if he's going to be on the field. I would imagine not. I would imagine he'd be up in the booth, you know, in the skybox, you know, shaking hands, kissing babies, doing all that stuff. I wouldn't be surprised if he made his way down to the field, but that's another thing that I don't think we've really talked about. Yeah, the roster's thin, but who's really going to be here to coach also?
Yeah. I mean, as unorthodox a situation as I can remember around LSU football playing a game with some 40 scholarship players, but they're going to give it a go tonight. Matt, what about TV tonight? What's your coverage going to look like?
Yeah, so obviously with the late kick, we won't be able to do a ton, you know, obviously for the late shows, but I'm going to be live here at 6 o'clock. Michael Cobble's going to be inside the PMAC, obviously covering the Kentucky-LSU basketball game and the Dale Brown court, you know, deal. And pretty much that's another thing, too. Like, this late kick just kind of throws everything off from a local coverage. Like, you're not going to be able to get hardly anything from anybody until, you know, tomorrow on TV. Like, obviously we'll do social media stuff, but it's just wild times we're living in, Matt. Like, if it hasn't gotten any weirder, it definitely, it's continuing that theme tonight.
The last bowl game of the college football season, of course, the national championship game still to be played, but this is the last bowl game of bowl season. Matt Trent from WBRZ. He is there covering the Texas Bowl with LSU and Kansas State. They'll kick it off tonight in about 3 hours and 20 minutes. Man, we appreciate a couple of minutes. Try not to get drowned out there by any other patriotic songs.
Yeah, I'll do my best.
All right, buddy. We'll see you. Happy New Year to you. That is Matt Trent. This is After Further Review. We're glad to have you hanging out with us here. Love telling you about GMFS Mortgage and GMFSMortgage.com. Changing lives since 1999. Home buy, refi, construction loans. Maybe if Christmas did a little damage on the bank account, GMFS Mortgage could help. Consider refinancing your mortgage. Lower your monthly mortgage payment. Skip a mortgage payment or two. Last year when Eric and I refied with GMFS Mortgage, we were able to skip 2 mortgage payments. I mean, do the math in your head. How much could that help your budget if you can skip 2 mortgage payments? Well, if they structure your refi or closing around certain dates, they can do that. GMFSmortgage.com. Check them out online. GMFSmortgage.com to find the local loan officer nearest you. GMFS Mortgage, changing lives. Matt did mention Brian Kelly. Brian Kelly, while he's there in Houston, did an interview with Fox 26 there in Houston. And look, it's obvious why Brian Kelly has not done a lot of media. Obviously, he had his introductory press conference. I believe he did an interview with the SEC Network on the Feinbaum Show. That's been about it. I think he maybe was on with Dan Patrick, perhaps. It's been scant, to say the least. But Houston is such an important recruiting area for LSU and certainly all of the state of Texas, which is why playing this game in Texas is also a big deal. They didn't go too deep dive into much, but they did ask Brian Kelly about, you know, competing, you know, in the importance of being competitive in this Texas Bowl game.
I think the outcome is less important than how they go out and play and compete, because all eyes are on them. The head coach is up there watching you. And so how you compete, how you go out there and represent the university is much more important.
But this is the soundbite that's gotten the most attention, because this is the one that matters the most. Brian Kelly is not mincing words at all as to why he's in Baton Rouge.
Our vision is clear. Win a national championship, recruit our base, come into the state of Texas and recruit heavily here as well. It starts with alignment from the very top, our president, athletic director, the entire university, working together to one goal, and that is to graduate our players and to win a national championship. And when you get that kind of alignment, you know, it's hard to say no, and that's why I'm here at LSU.
Graduate players, win a national championship. Y'all, it's why he's here. Like, he's done everything else. He's done everything else you can do. He's won at the Division II level. He's won at the mid-major level. He's won at the Power 5 level. He's had undefeated seasons. He's been in the playoff. He's been in the BCS National Championship game. He's had All-Americans. He's put guys in the NFL. He's the winningest active coach in college football. He's done everything except win a national championship. It is the reason he's here. It's why he's here. I think he's going to do it. There's no reason to believe he won't. The last three have done it. He's got a better resume now than any of them at the time they were hired. Their work's already begun. This is just a little after dinner drink is what tonight is. Just a little something to polish off the year while you really look forward to the future. All right. After further review, as we speak, they are unveiling Dale Brown Court at the Maravich Center. Certainly an emotional time that'll be had tonight, 15 minutes away from tip with LSU and Kentucky. One thing left to do, let's find out what we're betting on tonight. Jimmy Otto will join us. We'll get a pick for LSU, Kentucky, and, of course, the Texas Bowl as well. Stay here.
AFR.
Hey, look, we are cranking up those heaters now. We've been in a freeze warning the last couple of nights. We're getting down to freezing again tonight. Well, actually, low 46 tonight. But still, probably cold enough to where you're going to crank up that heater. If you're using your heater and you have not yet called River City's one-hour air, guys, I need you to do this. You need to call River City's one-hour air. The heater safety check. If you can't remember the last time you had your heater safety check, it's been too long. You should have this done seasonally. They'll come to your house. They'll get it clean, tuned up, efficient, and safe for the cold weather months. River City's one-hour air. The big yellow trucks with the giant clock on the side. You can't miss it. River City's one-hour air. Read the reviews. You'll see what I've seen over the years. Why I trust River City's one-hour air is why you should as well. 752-0001, where they're always on time, or you don't pay a dime.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by Insurance Network of Louisiana, call for a free quote to see how much you can save. 293-0450. After further review with Matt Moscona, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
We are about 11 minutes away from tip, LSU and Kentucky. So we got one thing left to do. Let's find out what we're betting on tonight. Time for Otter Locks.
Otter Locks, presented by Clark Crane Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in St. Francisville. Because a great deal is worth a short drive to Clark Crane.
So we turn to the one and only, the incomparable and often incomprehensible, the Ott Father himself, Jimmy Ott. Otter, how are you, man?
Oh, what a barn burner last night in Heinz Field. Huh? Wasn't that beautiful? 2.8 yards per attempt, and you win by double digits?
And Roethlisberger wouldn't even take off his helmet at the end for, like, the interviews or anything. He was just, like, refused to leave the field. It was super sappy and emotional, Otter.
Yeah, well, what was really sappy was he handed over the game ball to Kevin Stefanski because, I mean, you know, not handing the ball off to Nick Chubb with Baker Mayfield. I mean, really? Chubb ripped off 30. Okay, you sit on the bench reporter. I mean, it's just, hey, look, something smelled about that game. That's all right. We'll take it. We'll take it. And move along. Kentucky LSU, huh, Matty?
What we got?
First man. LSU basketball game I ever went to, 1978. Kentucky on their way to a national title, but Rudy Macklin as a freshman, Kenny Higgs as a senior, all 10 starters file out, and I was sold. I was done. I'm an LSU basketball fan for life. So, man, and speaking of Dale Brent, let me throw that out there, too, you know, as they honor him tonight. Starting this 31 years ago, some of Dale's teams kind of made my head scratch a little bit, and I would be highly critical because I thought they were more talented than what they were. Accomplishing sometimes and other times. Of course, the underdog role, he was much better. But, you know, critical. And let me say this. Mom died of cancer. I'm down about a week later. I received in the mail a 2.5-page handwritten note from Dale Brown. I mean, just reaching out to me. I mean, I'll have it. I'll keep it forever. I've seen him from time to time. He and EJ, when he was in fourth grade, saw him at Rupp Arena and always had time. And, you know, I'm happy for Dale. That he gets him. Because one thing that he and Will Wade both have in common, their effort. They were pushing, man. They had a high hill to climb and all that. And how fitting is it Kentucky? Because, boy, he had Kentucky square in the crossfires trying to not play underdog to the Kentucky Wildcats. Love LSU in this spot tonight. Don't overreact. We talked about you were gone last week, but we warned people last week. This is the roughest spot for LSU the whole season. First true road game in Auburn, hostile crowd. You throw in the fact that Brandon Murray was a late scratch, and we talked about on this segment last Wednesday. But now they come back, and this line's a little bit a little bit short. And I like LSU minus -2. Tonight in Kentucky on the home court. So we'll see, man. Traffic was rough, man. It's going to be a great game. Hopefully, the only thing that's in question, will they fill the student section? I hope so, because everywhere else is going to be pretty packed tonight. Got one other one in college hoops for you tonight. Okay. Illinois and Minnesota. Illinois, they had the COVID issues. This will be the first game they played in several weeks. Minnesota, the barn, is a tough place to play. I like your commentary earlier. I agree, but not for the entire season.
Okay.
But still in the early parts of the season, these true road games early are a little bit more exaggerated because there were no true road games last year. Again, I like Minnesota plus +6.5 at home in that one. And, boy, how about the bowl game tonight?
Yeah, what do you think, man? That line, Otters, touchdown. I mean, is it too much?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I hate to say it. State's spread 80% of the money as expected. And it reminds me of a couple of games. Earlier this year, Nevada lost their coach, their coordinators, and literally half their team. And still had to go to play Western Michigan. And they went from 7-point favorites to 7-point dogs. And they still lost by 28. and it was a 10 a.m. Monday morning game.
The 10 a.m.
But don't sleep on it. Don't sleep on it. So it was, and I'll get Paul Stone as a guest on ours. Still, you know, a lot of people want to claim I got it +3.5, -3 pick, whatever. He said still to touchdown, lay it. This is a difficult spot for LSU tonight. Yeah. Just the staff as well. See, because they were without half their staff also. Keep in mind that LSU still has that SEC emblem on them. Zero opt-outs for Kansas State in this game. I mean, listen, next man up. You can only take so far. I mean, please, it's going to be a tough spot for LSU. Last time wide receiver played quarterback? I remember a couple of games. January 1st, 2003 in the Super Bowl, Georgia against Florida State. Georgia opened up a pick, went off 7.5 because Florida State, back in the old days, would just suspend people because they wouldn't go to class or they did dumb stuff off the field. They had 15 games.
Crazy.
15 games, 15 guys out. And Quan Bolden played quarterback for the Florida State Seminoles. They lost 26-13. How about this one? December 29th, 2015. Baylor was out their leading rusher. Both quarterbacks, Seth Russell and Jared Stidham, the Biletnikoff Award winner, Corey Coleman. And he still rushed for a smooth 645 against North Carolina. Come on, Matt Brown. Put some people in the box. That was before Matt.
that was a guy from Southern Miss.
Hey, look, I
got like 8 seconds. I got to roll. But Fedora. That was Larry Fedora. Otter, have a great show.
Thank you, buddy.
We'll see you. He's at Doe's. See you tomorrow.
AFR.
Brought to you by Shabills Tire and Auto Service. ShabillsTire.com. 18 locations in South Louisiana. Find the location nearest you at ShabillsTire.com. Bumper to bumper auto service and name brand tires at wholesale prices. Here's what I would recommend you do. Of course, if the tires are looking a little bald and it's time, maybe you need a tire rotation or you need new tires, start at the website. Go to ShabillsTire.com. There's a promotions tab right there at the top. You tap the promotions tab and you can see every current promotion that they're offering. If it's the manufacturer's offer or if it's the Shabills in-house offer, like Shabills credit card. Shabills credit card, $50 off your first purchase with the Shabills credit card. So get an oil change, basically an oil change for free, or that could be an additional $50 off your tire purchase. It's at ShabillsTire.com, ShabillsTire.com. Find the location nearest you again at ShabillsTire.com. Remember, Shabills, where we keep you rolling.